hey y'all, welcome back to my channel. I know it's been about a week or so since I've been on here, but yeah, so I came to give y'all an update. I was supposed to give y'all an update on the car that I had got. Look guys, so let me tell y'all. So I bought the car, and it was a Mercedes GLB, right? It's smaller than a GLA. I mean, no, it's bigger than a GLA, and it's smaller than a GLC, a little bit smaller than a GLC. But I don't know, the car was small to me. I felt like it was small. So when I went and I picked my nephew up, and he was sitting in the bed with his car seat or whatever. I was like, yeah, man, this is small. It's kind of small. And then the seats just were not comfortable. I could tell in that vehicle on long drives that it would be uncomfortable because the seats were just kind of small. Now, this is me coming from a Honda Accord. Like, the Honda Accord, A1, like, for comfort and everything, like, A1 on the Honda Accord. But, you know, I wanted the truck. I didn't like the Passport. I didn't like the CRV, the look of the CRV. The Pilot was just too big for me. Like, we don't have a big family, so I didn't really need that big of a vehicle. But I did want, like, a mid-size SUV. And that one was more like a mini SUV or a compact SUV, something like that, if I should say it better. Compact SUV. So, when I bought the car, originally, I was like, okay, well, I'll see if I can make it work. I was thankful for the car. Don't make it seem like, I don't want it to seem like I'm ungrateful or whatever, but I was thankful for the car. But then, as I kept it for more days, it was just uncomfortable for me to drive. Like, the seats were just not comfortable. The blind spot mirrors, they were small. Like, it's a compact car, so everything is small. I felt like the gas and the brake pedal was too close together. I felt like if I'm trying to smash on the gas, my foot on the brake at the same time. So, that's just how I felt for me. Now, it could be some people who drive those and they love it, but for me, coming from the Honda, I just felt like I had more room in my Honda than in that car. Like, I really did. And I had a 2018 Honda Accord, for y'all that don't know. Now let's go into the day of purchase of the vehicle. Now, I'm not going to say this guy was a bad sales guy, I mean, because I went back to him again for the second vehicle. When we got the car, you know, we did all the paperwork and got down to the end. Paperwork, you know, at the end, before you leave, they're supposed to help. And Mercedes, they usually help set up the app, the Mercedes Me app, so you can use all the features in the car, you know. So when we got down to do the app, the car would not connect. So kind of found out that the car was missing a lot of the chips, like the chips to use, like the navigation, the app. And on the app is how you can lock your doors, you can start your car up from the app, you can pinpoint where your car is at. Like, the app has a lot of stuff on it that you can use, like, because they don't have automatic start on their keychain. If you want to automatic start your car, you have to do it from the phone. Let me go get the keychain. Hold on, y'all. Okay, so this is the keychain for the Mercedes. So all you have is lock, unlock your trunk, and then the hazard, whatever. So, like, the cars have automatic start, but you have to have the app to use the automatic start. And, you know, it's wintertime. You want an automatic start so your vehicle have it warm for when you go outside. It's already warmed up. So, they also gave me this little keychain too, y'all. Little Mercedes thing. So, they didn't give me this the first time, but they gave it to me the second time. So, when I got back to the chips, y'all, okay, so he was like, I was like, okay, so when the chips gonna be in? He's like, yeah, the chips will be in any day now. So, okay, I'm like, well, that's cool. He's like, so they make you sign a paper saying that when the chips come in, you'll bring the car in so they can put the chips in the car. Okay, so the car ended up having like some hard water spots on the mirror, and so I couldn't see out the mirror. Like, at night, it was hard for me to see out the mirror because of the hard water spots. And then keep in mind that the mirror was already small because this is a compact vehicle, so everything is smaller in the vehicle already. So, I took the car up there to have them get the water spots off of me, which they did there. They got the water spots off. I tried everything, y'all. I tried vinegar. I tried Windex. Nothing. It would not come off. So they had, apparently he said sometimes that whatever they wash the car with does that, and it leaves those hard water stains on the glass or the mirrors, but they have something to clean it off, so they got it off. But while I was up there, I was like, well, do you know when the chips are coming in? You know, now this is like almost a month later. Now, when I got the car, you told me the chips would be in any day. Now, if you say any day to me, I'm thinking 2-3 days it's going to be in. I'm going to bring the car back and put the chips in. So, he was like, well, we don't know when the chips gonna come in. What happened to any day? I mean, what happened to any day? Now is you don't know. So, I kind of felt a little cheated, if that makes sense. Like, this is my first Mercedes, and then when I get it, I don't get to even use all the features. I felt cheated. So, that just ain't fit well with me. So, me and my husband, we ended up going to Jeep, and I was like, I'll get a Jeep. I wanted a Jeep anyways. I wanted to take the doors off. I wanted to ride with the roof off and all that stuff like that. I was like, yeah, we can go to Jeep. I'll get a Jeep. And I just trade this car in because I'm on a big girl car. Not no damn, oh, hey. Nah, I need one to say, move, bitch, get out my way. So, look at some. We got Dodge dealership, you know, Dodge Jeeps, I think. We got Dodge dealership that we've been to, because my cousin had two Dodges. He had a Charger at one point and a Challenger at one point. So we've been up there a couple of times. So I was like, well, let me just see about the Jeep. So I went online, found the Jeep that they had everything that I wanted. Heated seats, cooling seats, leather seats. It had everything. It was a Jeep Wrangler Sahara. So when we get up there, now they had it online. They had like the, what do you call it, the fake pictures, not the picture of the actual car. So when I got up there, she was like, oh, we don't have that vehicle here. It's in transit. And I was like, well, it don't say in transit on the website, because usually when it's in transit, it'll have on the website in transit. Like, it's not on the lot, but it's coming. So she was like, well, let me go see when we'll get it. So she was like, well, it probably won't come for like another month or so. And I was like, shit, another month. I was like, all right. So I told her, she took our number down. She was like, when it come in, because they really didn't have nothing on the lot. It's like these car shortages, it's just like these homes. It's just not a lot out there. So she was like, when the Jeep come in, we'll call you or whatever. And you can come up here and we'll swap it out, whatever. So I was like, okay, cool. So I got home and I started thinking about it. And I was like, dang, I just got this Mercedes. I ain't had it but a month. I got all these warranty packages. Because she went down a rundown of everything, like, for the Jeep, what we were paid. And, like, I would have to get, like, all the warranty packages. Like, we usually get all the warranty packages. The maintenance package, the tire protection. Because your girl, you know, I tore up some rims. So I have to have the tire protection to protect the rims. Because I get a few curbs here and there, girl. And, tire protection, the key fob protection, because the key fob, it says like $700, and then the maintenance, where you don't pay maintenance for like 3 years or something like that. So I was like, I got all this stuff on the other car, and I said, well, let me just go back. I said, I haven't used any of the stuff, and I'm really not happy with the car because it don't have the chips. So I said, let me just go back to Mercedes and see if they would just swap all my warranty to another vehicle, and that way I can get the car that I want and then not really lose out on the warranties and stuff. Like the Gap, what else you have? We have Gap, extended warranty, which I know you can get the Gap and extended warranty back, but like the maintenance, the key fob, the, so much other stuff you can add on your car package or whatever, so, but we had all of it, so they ended up transferring the majority of it, except for one thing, like the key fob thing, which it was only like $260, they were like, they not gonna transfer that, I had to pay for a whole other key fob package, and then, it was one other thing, but it wasn't that much, still, I don't know, I saved by just going to get another Mercedes, then, risk losing all the warranty packages that I had just bought a month ago that I never used on the previous vehicle. So, anyways, I'll give y'all a car tour. I'll insert some pictures of the new car. Like, I'm in love with this car. I'm satisfied with this car because it's bigger, it's more room, and I went from a GLB to a GLE. So, the GLB is smaller, more compact, and the GLE is like, it's a meaty vehicle. Like, you got some. Yeah, you got some presence in that thing. It's a bigger vehicle. All right, guys. So I'll insert. I'll be back when I get in the car. Okay, like I was saying, so I ended up getting the GLE. It has a sports package, but this is the inside of the car. The other car, the seats was like light tan. But this one is like a dark brown. You can see the seat. Yeah, so this one's like a dark brown. it has the ambient lighting, and everything. It has the panoramic sunroof. It has the panoramic sunroof. It has the lighting up like the Mercedes. When you get out the car, it has the Mercedes emblem on the ground. What else it does? You can talk to the car. You can say like, "Hey Mercedes." I don't know if y'all can hear it again. "Hey Mercedes.
How may I help you?"
Close sunscreen.
"I'm closing the roller sun blinds."
See, like, you can talk to the car. It got a lot of little, like, you can say, "Hey, Mercedes.
How can I help?"
"I'm cold."
"I'm increasing the temperature to 74 degrees.
See, so, like, you can talk to the car and everything. Okay, this is the dashboard I was telling y'all about. It's like one big-ass iPad, basically. Like, this controller controls this screen. And this controller controls this screen. It's two screens, if you can tell. And this screen is touch screen, and this screen is not touch screen. So this one you can touch. You can control it here, or you can control it with this little touchpad thing here. But yeah, it has the ambient lighting. Let's see. You can choose from whatever color. I think I have mine now on multicolor. but you can choose the brightness. I got mine all the way up. Choose the brightness and the colors. Let's see if I go. Let's see, this is all the colors you can choose from. You know, so, but I like the multicolor. This is not the multicolor I like. Not that one. That's the multicolor I like. Going. I have the multicolor. I have blue and yellow. If you can see, like here is blue, and that's some yellow. They have stuff to the seat kinetics. It's like if you're driving for a long time, the seats will vibrate to make sure you awake or whatever. What else? Like with the other car that I had, remember I told you I didn't have no chip, so I couldn't use like the navigation, like the net. I'm gonna put my hand right here for my address. I couldn't use like the navigation or whatever. Then you have your media, of course, your comfort, your seating, your lighting, your seating, and then this is just other info like about the car. This is the app, the Mercedes Me app stuff, and then this is just the settings in the car, which is just like your assistant, I got camera and parking, like it does parking for you, your brake assist, attention assist, blind spot, and all that other stuff. And then these are drive modes, I think. No, it's not. I don't know what this is. Dynamic. Okay. I don't know what that is. I have to figure it out later. This belt adjustment is like when you put your seatbelt on, it tighten up on you. This is an acoustic lock. That's like if you wanted to honk when you lock the door. I have that on, and I have the belt lock on, belt adjustment. This is automatic folding. Like when you lock your door, your windows automatically fold, and the automatic lock, door lock. That's that. And then the lighting. This is like just your interior lighting, exterior lighting, and all of that. And this is the cool thing about the display, y'all. The display, you can change the display. Like, if you don't want it to be sports, you can change it to progressive. You can change it to classic. You can change it to, I like the sport. So, that's what I usually use. The sport. So let me see what else about this car. It has the lighting on the side, like when you this is another thing. Like this is the gear shift right here. Like to push in is park, up is reverse, down is drive, or whatever. It does have push starts here, and with that what is that called? Where it cuts off when you stop at the red lights or whatever. But this is how you cut it off. I can't remember what it's called. But I'm gonna cut the car off, because I'm finna get out the car. But let me show y'all. I didn't get the wireless charging. I didn't get that. It's just my mask. I just got my... It has the... what is the new cord called? The C cord for the iPhone? The USB-C? That's what it is. The USB-C. That's what it has in here. But on the Mercedes Me app, you get all the alerts for your phone. I mean, for your phone. All the alerts for the car to your phone. Like, if you left your door unlocked, you can start your car from the app. And they gave me this cool keychain. So this is the door. When I get out, it got the lit up Mercedes. It's just a little small details for me. So when I get out, on the other car, I wanted the lights on the side, which I didn't think I had it. And then my husband said, "You got the lights on the side of the car, so y'all can see. Y'all see the Mercedes light." Yeah. So this is a sports package. So. Excuse my junkie garage. This is a sports package, so it did come with the diamond studded grill. And I got it in a blue, y'all. This blue is so pretty. And then it did come with the AMG, if y'all can see, the AMG rims. So, and it's a nice trick. When I lock the doors, I just set the setting to beep and the mirrors to fold when I lock the door. So let's see, y'all. Oh, Okay, guys, I'll insert more pictures of my car. All right. Oh, yeah, I'll insert some pictures at the end. But, oh, let me show y'all the bag. Hold on, y'all. Let me unlock it. Okay, so this is the bag. And the bag has the same thing like the Mercedes that lights up. You have a, what is this bag? A USB-C and an actual, no, this one doesn't have, this one doesn't have the actual plug. The other one had, oh yes it does, this is it. This is the actual plug, like a plug like in the house plug. And then you have two USB-Cs back here. Got your vents back here. And the seats are like a nice brown, dark brown. And then it has like wood grain and stuff. I don't know if y'all can see because it's kind of dark. But yeah, it has like wood grain. Wood grain, maybe I can see it now. See the wood grain? And it's like this brown color. Yeah. Okay. Let's see, guys.